while the resin is still wet and it's uncured, I'm gonna get my 12 blade and just run quite a deep craze line all the way through that dentine layer. Add a little bit of interest elsewhere there with my top face scalpel. Right, just smooth that out and just twist it on number three brush. I'm just widening up my little craze line there. Remember, this is macro, so this is very, very fine touches that we're making. And once I've got that cured now, I've got a really different kind of dentine layering to my younger tooth. I'm gonna come in here with my tint. You can use a little mix of light, dark brown, depending on what kind of craze line darkness that you want to achieve. I'm just letting that tint sit in there and see what kind of effect that's gonna have. I don't mind if a little bit spreads onto that midway split point, because I want quite an aged effect there in the tooth. Making sure I've got a nice little spread of the tints. If you think you've got any excess, you can kind of dab that out, either with a brush or with a micro brush. Make sure it's really seamed into my craze line there. And you can see that scrows, those two little scrows dentine spots, just really interesting. A little bit too much. I'll take them a little bit out with my micro brush. A little cure. That's looking. And now all I'm doing is just adding an extra bit of warmth running through the middle of the tooth over the top of that craze line. And some of these are extra effects that you wouldn't have to go through all of these clinically, but I'm choosing to do it to really try and create something of interest and special for you guys to look at the end. And again, any kind of too much excess, take it away with a micro brush. So we've almost, you know, created this little 3D sculpture painting.